在今年三月的时候，我有讲过哈，我有提到有一个犹大拉比嘛哈，他叫做 Judah Ben Samuel， 他在西元1100年的时候，他预言以色列有这么样的一个预言哈，这是他的预言的一段话哈，预言的一段话，他说他以色列将会被占据之后的50周年，有500年啊。就是在2017年将会觉醒，进入弥赛亚时代。那他的 prophecy， 他是他讲的哈 ，when the Ottoman 就是奥斯曼帝国征服耶路撒冷哈，那他们将会被统治啊，八个 jubilee， 一个 jubilee 是几年啊？
50年
啊，八个 jubilee 就是400年，啊，400年。然后阿波罗之后呢，那耶路撒冷会become non man's land， 啊，就是没有人居住的地方 ，for one jubilee， 啊，啊，然后呢 ，then 啊，50年，然后 then in 10th jubilee， it will once again come back into possession of the Jewish nation， 然后再经过十个 jubilee 就500年，啊，十个 jubilee 500年，它会啊就会。归回到这个犹太人的这个 nation 的手中，然后同时呢，就是这个十个 jubilee 之后呢，啊，第十个 jubilee 哈 ，tenth 嘛哈，第十个 jubilee 之后呢 ，which would signify the beginning of the Messiah end time， 啊，会提到就是说，那这个第十个 jubilee 之后呢，就是一个。弥赛亚时代的开始，啊，弥赛亚时代的开始。那我有在想说，到底什么是弥赛亚时代？就是到底这弥赛亚时代的意义，就是表示什么东西啊？这是什么意义吗？好，弥赛亚时代，啊，记得我3月份的时候，我有跟大家提到，我想到的一个就是说，弥赛亚时代就表示说。这个日子的这个日子，犹太就是外邦人的数目满足了，外邦人的数目满足了，然后犹太人都要信主，啊，那时候犹太人都要信，犹太人信主不是说一下子所有犹太人都信主，而是开始犹太人开始大量的信主，啊，有外邦人的数目满足了，那在弥赛亚时代开始就是，啊，外邦就是那个犹太人要开始大量的信主。那记得我在叫4月还是9月的时候，那我有提到就是说那时候 Chris 嘛哈，我们 Chris 他有做一个统计哈，就是从2015年、2016年，那犹太人信主的这个人数哈，啊，突然就大量的增加，突然大量增加，然后在这个。今年当中，我们也提过，就是说在以色列有好一些特会啊，在有些以色列的这个特会当中，犹太人成千的信主，成千的决志，啊，成千的以色列犹太人决志，啊，所以那我相信这个弥赛亚时代的开始呢，就象征的就是犹太人。会大量的信主，哦，犹太人大量，而且是在以色列，在以色列这个地方，哦，那，为什么呢？为什么会在以色列这个地方？那因为，有人说哈，就是说在聚居在外的哈犹太人哈，那他们若是不回归以色列的话哈，他们很难信主，哦。因为在外面的话，他们若是不回归以色列的话，他们一直就是被同化，被当地同化啊，被同化，或者呢，那就是被那个逼迫啊，等等啊，所以那一定是要他们回到以色列，回到以色列。那所以呢，弥赛亚时代另外一个意义呢？我觉得就是会有大量的犹太人呢，会回归以色列，啊，会回归以色列，又在开始有另外一波大量的以色列犹太人呢 回归，开始回归以色列，哦，开始回归以色列。所以这是我想到的两个方面，就是弥赛亚时代的来临，是用意义象征的，就是说一个就是犹太人大量进入，第二个呢，犹太人外地的犹太人要回归。那因为犹太人回归呢，那另外我之所以就会这样想，另外一个也是说，在历史上这个七十年哈，就是今年2017年是这个犹大这个以色列就是联合国他这个决议啊，什么福尔曼还是什么决议啊，联合国的那个决议就是把这块土地就是还给以色列哈，还给犹太人，就是1947年啊，1947年，那70年啊，这70年的这个 cycle 呢，那也是那个以色列被掳归回七十年，那另外呢，以色列归回被掳归回呢，是在那个波斯的那个古列王的时候，那这个川普总统还没当选之前，那就有预言嘛，就是川普会是这个有古列王的灵在他的身上啊，归回。那所以七十年好像是一个归回的一个 cycle 这样。好，那下面第二个就是说，他这个拉比的预言哈，1217年啊，1217年到1517年啊，这个好像是1217是，等一下大家看一下那个 clip 啊，还有提到1217好像是他的预言的时候还是什么时候忘了啊，大家也看一下，然后从1517开始啊，1517就是奥斯曼占这个耶路撒冷，然后经过了这个八个 Jubilee 啊，400年啊，然后呢，再经过一个 Jubilee 50年呢，就是没有任何的人在管理这个地啊，然后再经过这个50年啊，就是1967到1967是那个六日战争嘛。哦，六日战争，以色列把它拿回来。到2017，这50年，2017，那川普正式宣布，就是说他承认那个耶路撒冷是这个犹太人以色列的首都啊，这个，所以说 total 这样子十个 Jubilee 500年，到2017。所以那之后呢，弥赛亚时代来临，这是这个拉比他做的预言，他做的预言呢，这个都已经实现了。好，那我们就看一下他这个第一个。
The rabbis made an outstanding prediction about the future of Jerusalem and the coming of the Messiah. The prophecy by Judah ben Samuel.When the Ottomans conquer Jerusalem, they will rule over Jerusalem for 8 Jubilees. Afterwards, Jerusalem will become no man's land for 1 Jubilee. And then in the 10th Jubilee, it will once again come back into the possession of the Jewish nation, which would signify the beginning of the Messianic end time. During the Roman Christian Crusades,The Mamluk began the reign in Jerusalem in the year of 1250 CE, when the last Ayyubid Sultan of Egypt, Tu Ranshah, was assassinated by his Mamluk slave, General Ibik. Ibik then founded the Mamluk Bari dynasty. They held power over Jerusalem until they were conquered by the Ottoman Turks in the year of 1517. 300 years after the death of Rabbi Judah ben Samuel. We know again by history that the Ottoman Turks gained control of Jerusalem in the year 1517 and held power over Jerusalem for 400 years. 50 years by eight jubilees. When they were conquered in 1917 by the British military forces under the command of British military general Edmund Allenby on Hanukkah, December 17, 1917. Is it not amazing that from the year of 1917, when the British mandate controlled the city of Jerusalem and it became under international law a no man's land for one jubilee, it was 50 years after that year in 1917 that the Israeli army captured the city of Jerusalem in the Six-Day War on June 17, 1967, exactly one jubilee later. Theodor Herzl, considered the father of Zionism. He organized the first Zionist Congress in Basel in 1897. After the Congress, Herzl wrote in his diary, "At Basel, I founded the Jewish state. If not in 5 years, certainly in 50, everyone will know it." Exactly 50 years after the state of Israel became a reality. That day declares Jehovah, I shall gather in the lame and bring together the strays and those whom I have treated harshly. From the footsore I shall make a remnant, and from the far-flung a mighty nation, and Jehovah will reign over them on Mount Zion thenceforth and forever. Micah 4, 6 and 7. On the 2nd of November, 1917, Arthur James Balfour with his declaration gave a chance to the Jewish people to rebuild its national home, Elia. Exactly 50 years later, Jerusalem was reunited. Australian light horsemen first opened the way for Jerusalem. Look, the days are coming, Jehovah declares, when people will no longer say, as Jehovah lives who brought the Israelites out of Egypt, but as Jehovah lives who brought the Israelites back from the land of the north and all the countries to which he had driven them. I shall bring them back to the very soil I gave their ancestors. Jeremiah 16, 14 and 15. On the 29th of November 1947, the UN adopted the Resolution 181 for the creation of a Jewish state, Eretz Israel. Who hath heard such a thing? Who hath seen such things? Shall a land be born in one day? Shall a nation be brought forth at once? Or as soon as Zion travailed, she brought forth her children. Shall I bring to the birth, and not cause to bring forth, saith Jehovah? Shall I that cause to bring forth shut the womb, saith thy God? Isaiah 66, 8 and 9. In 1967, Jerusalem returned for the first time to the control of the Jewish-Israeli ownership since the day when Jerusalem was destroyed in 70 CE. The date indicates also the end of a long period given to the Gentiles. And they shall fall by the edge of the sword, and shall be led away captive unto all nations, and Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles, until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled. Luke 21 verse 24. The Lord will possess Judah as his portion in the Holy Land, and will again choose Jerusalem. Zechariah 2:12. Marks the fulfillment of the 10 jubilees prophesied by Judah ben Samuel. Unbiblical periods 120,170, 50 years. 120 years since Theodor Herzl Congress. 100 years since Balfour Declaration, 70 years since the creation of a Jewish state, 50 years since Jerusalem redemption. And Jesus went out and departed from the temple, and his disciples came to him for to show him the buildings of the temple. And Jesus said unto them, See ye not all these things? Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left here one stone upon another, that shall not be thrown down. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, Tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming, and of the end of the world? Matthew 24, 1, 3. Now learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender, and putteth forth leaves, ye know that summer is nigh. So likewise ye, when ye shall see all these things, know that it is near, even at the doors. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass, till all these things be fulfilled. Matthew 24, 32, 34. The generation which Christ refers to lasts 70 years. Psalm chapter 90 verse 10. Since the temple was destroyed in 70 CE, with the cessation of the priesthood and the beginning of the diaspora, also the historical state of Israel officially ceased to exist. In the Bible, the fig tree represents the nation of Israel. Hosea chapter 9 verse 10, Jeremiah chapter 24 verse 5. So by the time the Messiah comes, the Israel fig will have been reviving for 70 years, the period of the generation, 1947-48, 2017-18. In these past 70 years, there have been three unique blood moons tetrads, exactly in coincidence with biblical Feast of Passover and Feast of Tabernacles. The first one in the period of the founding of the Israel state. The second one at the reunification of Jerusalem to the Jewish people. And the third one we does not know the precise meaning yet. September 23rd, 2017. Jewish Feast of Rosh Hashanah of the Jewish New Year. There will be a fulfillment in astronomical form of Revelation chapter 12. We will see the alignment of stars and planets like Saturn, Moon, Earth, Jupiter, Sun, Mercury, Mars, Venus, and the star Regulus, which means king. Also, the constellation of Leo depicts the tribe of Judah or the king Messiah. The constellation of Virgo in its feet will be the moon right between its legs. You will find the planet Jupiter, considered the king of the planets, for its size. The constellation of Virgo around will be illuminated by the sun. In fact, we will not see during daylight, and on its head there will be 12 stars. Now a great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and a crown of 12 stars on her head. She was pregnant and cried out in her pangs and anguish of childbirth. Revelation 12, 1, 2. What happens in autumn upon expiry of these divine times connected with Israel people? The people chosen by Jehovah. The people scattered and gathered in this last century according his promise. After thousands years, and the people of God's covenant. Time will tell.
外邦人还是会继续的有人得救，那这是一个。那另外一个就是说，刚刚他讲到的一些星象哈，星象。那我想我们可能有些人已经知道了哈。那像他讲到今年9月23号哈，那个在那个祝棚节9月23号，哎，不是，是应该是那个。那个缺角节呢，9月20，就是在犹太人新年嘛，哈，犹太人新年那附近， 那个天象啊，就是有那个天象，就是他们就是把它画出来的话，就好像是启示录十二章讲到的那个妇人，然后都带着十二个星嘛，哈，然后这样的一个意象嘛，哈，那这些都是一个 sign 啊，那我想我们大家都把它当作一个 sign， 一个sign， 那让我们知道，就是说，因为耶稣也叫我们知道说，我们要去留意 watch 啊，留意这些 sign， 那所以我们知道是什么时候啊，那这些 sign 的话，我们看到了，那就表示说是耶稣来的日子真的是近了，耶稣来的日子真的是近了，就是这样子。那我们不是要，我们可以，我们是要做一个 watcher， sign watcher， sign watcher， 留意这个 sign。 那我们不是要去做一个 sign setter， setter， 就是我们不是要定时间说，哦，这个像我们会听到很多人讲，哦，耶稣什么时候什么时候哪一年什么时候会来哈，哦，那我们不是这样做，因为圣经讲说耶稣来的日子没有人知道嘛，哈，没有人知道什么时候什么时辰来到，但是我们要去，我们要 watch 这个 sign，watch 这个 sign。好，那第二个 clip 呢？第二个 clip 呢，我是要让大家看一下，这是就是以前我们放过他的那个信息啊，就是澳洲的牧师叫 Stephen 啊 ，Stephen 那个牧师他讲到他讲了很多这个 end time 的那个信息，那这个呢，这个 clip 呢，他讲到的就是说他是用这个诗篇啊，诗篇来解释这个end time， 他用诗篇117篇。当作2017年，然后诗篇118篇来解释2018年会发生什么事，诗篇119篇要解释，用来解释2019年会发生什么事。我相信他有一定有他的道理，我相信他一定有他的道理。为什么诗篇117是2017年，118是2018年，119是2019年，他一定有他的道理，我没有去花时间去找，有可能是希伯来的这个数字这样的对应到。那 however， 但是我觉得可以给大家做参考一下，我觉得是蛮有蛮好的。那2017年他就讲到说是诗篇117篇，或者是很最短的一篇啊，很短的一篇，就是哈雷路亚啊，你们要赞美耶和华啊。好，2017年我们真的是在赞美耶和华啊，那个川普总统啊当选啊，那美国有一个2017年就刚刚讲到也是这个弥赛亚时代的开始，那2018年呢？2018年就是诗篇118篇，那有提到就是战争，还有那个拯救以色列的战争，还有拯救被拯救啊。那这个川普一宣布这个承认耶路撒冷是以色列的首都以后，大家都很紧张嘛，哈，那特别是这些周围的中东的回教阿拉伯的国家，他们都反对嘛，哈，那大家那大家不约而同的就提到说，哎，这个好像是这个撒加利亚书12:2-3的 fulfillment 啊，撒加利亚书12:23第二节第三节啊，大家可以看一下，在我那个
东耶路撒冷
PowerPoint，
其实这一本
最后一页，在下面，啊，对，那就十二章，他都讲到说啊，耶和华论以色列的末世啊，铺张诸天，建立地基，造人里面治理的耶和华说，我必使耶路撒冷被围困的时候，向四围的列国的名称为令人昏醉的杯。这末世也论到犹大啊，犹大也是不是啊？那日我必使耶路撒冷像聚集攻击他的万民，当作一块重石头，凡举起的必受重伤啊！所以大家就在想说，那、这个耶路撒冷会被围困啊！就川普一宣布这个时候，那很多国家都，他这个以色列周围的国家都抗议嘛，啊，要抗议。那，就好像这个事情会发生啊，那。好，那但是我们再回到前面一个是吧？但是在诗篇118篇啊，诗篇118篇中，我们一起来念一下啊。我在急难中求告耶和华，他就应允我，把我安置在宽阔之地。有耶和华帮助我，我必不惧怕。人能把我怎么样呢？在那帮助我的人中有耶和华帮助我，所以我要看见那恨我的人遭报。投靠耶和华，强势以待人；投靠耶和华，强势以待王子。万民围绕我，我靠耶和华的名必剿灭他们。他们环绕我，围困我，我靠耶和华的名必剿灭他们。他们如同疯子围绕我，好像烧荆棘的火，必被熄灭。我靠耶和华的名必剿灭他们。你推我，要叫我跌倒，但耶和华帮助了我。耶和华是我的力量，是我的诗歌，他也成了我的拯救。在异人的帐篷里有欢呼拯救的声音，耶和华的右手施展大能，耶和华的右手高举，耶和华的右手施展大能。我必不致死，人要存活，并要传扬耶和华的作为。耶和华虽严严审治我，却未曾将我交于死亡。好，这是诗篇118篇，所以等一下那个 Stephen 牧师他会借着这诗篇118篇来解释说，2018年以色列会发生些什么事情。那诗篇119篇的话，大家知道119篇是最长的一篇，所以他说2019年我又比 long 一点。好，那我们就先来看一下他的这个 key， 我们看一半，不会都看。119我们就先不看了。
So, we're coming to 2017. Anybody want to know about 2017, or you had enough? Well, Psalm 2017, there's not much we can say, because it's the shortest psalm. It's the shortest psalm. It's the shortest chapter in the Bible. What does that mean? Your guess is as good as mine, I think, but we would say Psalm 117 corresponds to 2017, and here's what it says. You can read it together with me. 1, 2, 3. Oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations. Praise Him, all ye people. For His merciful kindness is great toward us, and the truth of the Lord endureth forever. Praise ye the Lord. And in Hebrew, that's Hallelujah Jehovah, or Hallelujah Yahweh, whichever name you want to. It's a tetragrammaton, no vowel, so YHWH. I'd say Yahweh. So, Hallelujah. That's where we get
Hallelujah! So it starts with Hallelujah, it ends with Hallelujah, and it refers to the nations, which is us, the Gentiles, the non-Jews. So what could happen in 2017 that would make it a very short year and make everyone go, Hallelujah? You guess. But we know for sure there's a major sign coming up in the sky, the sign of the woman giving birth to the king, 12 stars on her head that correlates to the dream of Joseph. You can do your study, moon at her feet, sun at her hair, happening on the 23rd of September, 2017. Major sign coming up. So just for this reason alone, I'm going to tell everybody listening, you got no time to be depressed. You got no time. You got no time to be anxious, to be depressed, to be sad, to be forlorn. You got no time. Find something. Move forward. Find something useful to do in your church. If you're not going to church, I encourage you to get back to church. If you don't have a church, treat us like a church. If we're feeding you, you're listening to us on YouTube. I never used to say this, but I'm saying it now. We find people contact us from all over the world. They don't have a church to go to. They're in some remote place. They're in a place where there's no Bible-believing, Bible-teaching church. Treat us like your church. Come in fellowship. Get feeding. Send your tithe and offering. If you have a church, do not send your tithe. If you don't have a church, you can't. All right? But let's have a global community, a global fellowship. Let's get in obedience to God. Let's get ready. Right? Instead of being offended. Well, this church hurt me. This pastor hurt me. Yeah, I can tell you stories of pastors who do wrong things. I know them. I know they do wrong things. I know. They don't do the Bible. They don't check. They gossip as much as anybody. They believe gossip as much as anybody. I understand. But am I offended? No. I forgive them. Let the Lord deal with them. The Lord or the devil will deal with them. Ain't my business. Ain't my business. I'm not here to judge anybody. I'm here to complete my race. And I don't make it my business to hurt other people, expose other people, blah, 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 blah. We've got no time. All right? So if you're hurt, offended, get back into fellowship. Don't carry that because the rapture might not be for everybody. You got to get ready. Another day, next time, I'm going to show you lots and lots of scriptures to answer the question once and for all. People think, do all the Christians get raptured or not get raptured? All right, well, don't take people's opinion. Let's have lots and lots and lots of scriptures on this subject. I'll do that another time. So 2017, the shortest year, the shortest song, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, happy, 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 sounds very good. I'm looking forward. I'm excited. I'm not afraid of the end time. Amen? No matter what happens, if I have to stay, I'll preach the gospel. They have to cut off my head for believing Jesus, take my head. I'm going to heaven. Amen? What do I got to lose? What do I got to lose? I believe Jesus. I believe heaven. I believe heaven. Right? Forever and ever and ever. Oh, praise God. 2018. Now, I got to do 2018 because I didn't say it's all going to end in 2017 necessarily. It does keep going. So let me just give you a little bit more. 2018. 2018 seems to me to really mesh with this timeline that a lot of prophetic teachers are kind of figuring out. Tribulation. 2018, if it correlates to Psalm 118, it looks a lot like a tribulation psalm. What do I mean? Well, it says in verse 5, I called upon the Lord in distress. The Lord answered me and set me in a large place. All nations compass me about. So you got distress. You've got armies of the nations surrounding Israel. They compass me about, verse 11 says, yea, they compass me about. Okay, I think we get it. Israel is going to be surrounded by enemy forces. Three times it's repeated. The Lord is my strength and my song, and is become my salvation. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord has chastened me sore, but he has not given me over to death. Well, that's what the tribulation is. Is Israel has been so secular, has rejected Christ, the Messiah, since 32 AD, has gone the secular way. Most Jews can't even quote the Bible, don't read their Torah every day anymore, wouldn't even know the content of the Bible. They've become so secular and so anti-Messiah that their time of judgment will come. But it is a chastening for life, for them to come back to the Messiah, not to kill him. And so the Lord, during the tribulation, will chasten Israel's sword, but he will not give all of Israel over to death. Sounds a lot like the outline of the tribulation. It is also the Salvation Psalm 2018. Some famous verses that we quote, maybe you don't know, comes from Psalm 118. This is the day which the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. Yeah, you know this song. I will rejoice and celebrate. Okay, so I wake up most mornings, I say, praise the Lord, good morning, Father, good morning, Holy Spirit. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Okay, where does this come from? Psalm 118. Blessed, and then Jesus quoted this, blessed be he who comes in the name of the Lord. He quotes it in Luke 13, verse 35, you shall not see me until the time come when you say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Well, would it be awesome if Psalm 118 is fulfilled in the year 2018, and the Jews call upon the name of the Lord and say, blessed be he who came. Who came? Born in Bethlehem, like Micah said. Died for the iniquities of the Jews, like Isaiah 53 said. Fulfill all of these. He's the seed of the woman, born of a virgin. Wouldn't it be awesome if this gets fulfilled by coincidence, year 2018? Would correspond, wouldn't it? Right? So we're projecting into the future. We can't say for certain. We're not dogmatic. We don't need to be. We still live our lives for Jesus. We're not watching dates. We're watching the Lord. But it'd be uncanny if it happened then. The salvation song gets fulfilled for many Jews. You, as a Jew, if you're listening, you can accept Jesus in 2018. You can accept him before and after. His name is Yeshua in Hebrew. He's not the Gentile enemy of the Jews. He's the Jewish Savior. He's the one that fulfills all the longings and all the prophecies since Moses, even since Adam. Look it up yourself. All right. So, did you know God has singled out Psalms 113 to 118 and called them the Hallel Psalms? Anyone know that? They're called Psalms of Praise, and they're sung during Passover, Pentecost, Tabernacles, and Hanukkah. So now the three main feasts that they got to get to, the Jews got to get to, according to the Old Testament, they can't do that anymore because there's no temple, because the Messiah's already come, because the Messiah's already walked into the temple. That's how you know he's the Messiah. But when they could, those in Israel went to Jerusalem three times a year at Passover, Pentecost, and Tabernacles. Those are the feasts all believers are told to keep, not just Jews, but even Christians. Celebrate the Lord during the holy days. And then they added Hanukkah, the cleansing of the temple that was defiled by the Syrian king, Antiochus IV. These psalms of praise are sung on all the major holidays. Is that like a major clue? Psalm 113 to 114 is sung before the Passover feast. Psalm 115 to 118 are sung after the Last Cup. In other words, these are the likely songs that Jesus and his disciples sang at the First Communion. These were the words they sung, being prophetic of the time you and I are living in. Wow! 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 Every time we have communion, we should be thinking year 2013 to 2018. That's what we've been waiting for. And it has come. We're right in the thick of it. Why did God highlight these psalms? They seem to be pointing us to a major time, a major prophetic time of fulfillment, 2013 to 2018. Last one, what about 2019? Well, 2019, we know, is unique. So all of these things...
大家可以回去大家今天没有时间我们就先为这个以色列的救恩来祷告求神持续的叫犹太人得救神奇神迹奇事在犹太人当中持续的爆发第二个求神打开他们心中的眼睛好叫他们能够知道他们应当有怎样的产业因为救恩本来就属于他们好不好好
因为弥赛亚时代来临了，犹太人都要信主啊，要大有的信主，我们就为他们的救恩来祷告。好，好，那我们现在起立啊，我们起立。